Hi Barnab Kennedy, John here. This is going to be my contest entry to Sloop John H and his contest. Got a few questions written down here that he asked that I'll attempt to answer. While I do that, at least in the beginning anyway, I'm spinning this, Nina Simone. Nina Simone sings the blues. Grooving to that. Okay. So John asks for us to tell about the music that our parents listened to. And I have to say that my parents weren't particularly sort of interested in music so much, really. Particularly my father, I don't believe he's ever really shown much interest in music at all, as far as I know. I'll tell you this though, that he really doesn't like the Beatles. He was born in 1930, so he's from a generation of people that remember music before, you know, drums and bass. And, you know, he describes it as just everything sounds like thump, 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 thump all the time. That's his, you know, that's his view, I guess. I don't think it's so uncommon, to be honest with you. There you go. So he's never really kind of played any music, as far as I know. He listens to the talk radio, BBC Radio 4, and always has done since I've been a child. And I do that now, of course. Quite enjoy it. I will say my mother, although she never really kind of played music very much, before I was born, sort of the tail end of the 60s, and I think maybe at the very beginning of the 70s, she actually ran a youth club in my village where I come from. And what they used to do apparently was every week they would buy a single from the top 10. So there'd be a new 7-inch single that they bought every week. And of course from that time, the top hits, you know, more or less were, you know, some of the Beatles 7-inch singles, Elvis Presley, of course, lots of other big names. But also, you know, they weren't sort of afraid of buying some of the more sort of one-hit wonder type songs, or the comedy records, or the what's the word I'm looking for, the novelty songs that came sort of into the charts at that time. So I grew up as a very small child having access to this stack of, I guess about a stack about that high, of 7-inch singles from the 60s and 70s, early 70s, and I used to play them. I mean, yeah, we didn't sort of treasure them as sort of like people may do now, so there was never any kind of problem with me playing these old records. And I haven't seen them for a while. I think they're kind of moved to a separate part of the family now, but I can remember that they were well worn and well played, and you know, not really fantastic condition by the time they'd passed through, you know, me and my brothers and sisters and things like that. So those songs are sort of my memories of music from my mother, I guess, as a child. I'm going to play some of them. I don't have the singles, but I'll look them up on YouTube and film little snippets of those songs. I'm not going to bother the Beatles and the Elvis Presley numbers because everybody knows them, but some of the, you know, the lesser known ones from that time, you might find it interesting to hear.
He's a real tasty geezer. He's grown his hair a bit, but it's smooth, not too long. And he wears a baseball shirt with a number 17 on. He looks great in his big white basketball boots. He's stupid over football and he looks me in the eye when he shoots. Reggae, 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 here comes Johnny Reggae. Johnny Reggae, reggae, lay it on me. Reggae, 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 here comes Johnny Reggae. Johnny Reggae, reggae, lay it on me.
Okay, John's next question was record would like to be reissued. Well, I've shown this recently. This is a CD of an album that I'd really like to have reissued. This is Angler Gord Hybris. It's a Swedish progressive rock album by a band called Angler Gord. I got it signed from the band. And what can I tell you about it? It's incredible. It's as far as I know, it's the best progressive rock album I know of. I really like prog. This came out in the early 90s. I think it was just released because it's mainly instrumental, but there is some vocals on it, but they're in Swedish. So I guess it was released on a sort of domestic market. Small numbers, it's not a large population in Sweden. It's a tremendously, really fantastic album. Certainly easily in my top five, I would say, of all time. But to get it on vinyl, you know, it cost an absolute fortune to buy it. There are so few of them and they're so highly, you know, regarded. I think it'd be really good if this band reissued this on vinyl, because I'm sure they would sell a shedload of records if they did. I certainly would buy it, but I haven't seen it reissued, and I don't think there were any plans to reissue it, but I think that's a real shame. Indeed, I mean, there's lots of really good progressive rock. It's kind of a niche thing, I suppose, but there's lots of really good prog rock that has been happening over the past decade and is still happening, particularly in Scandinavia. Those kind of bands, they release their music as digital files or CDs, but many of them don't put their stuff onto vinyl, which I think is a crying shame. I really do think that's could turn things around if they considered that. So, okay, the next question was best blind buy. This, without a doubt, is my best blind buy. It's a jazz record, and it's possibly one of the jazz records that has sort of turned me on to having any interest in jazz at all. And I don't know if you saw my video about my best sounding record that I own. Well, this is it. You know, this is, I can't explain it. Words fail me. It's so there's great sound on this album. So I would say, and I bought that completely on a whim. I had no idea who these people were. I'm quite familiar with them now, but when I picked it up, I knew zilch. So that's certainly one of them, but I'll show a different one because I've already shown that one recently. This is an album which I bought a long time ago, a decade ago, I suppose. It's Ike and Tina Turner. Anyone that knows me, at the time when I was sort of bought this, I was still probably listening to heavy metal quite a lot. And possibly getting into some more of the progressive rock type stuff. And, you know, anyone that knows me would say, well, Jim, John doesn't listen to Tina Turner, you know, what's all that about? What is he buying that for? But this is a really good record. I bought it just sort of, I don't really know why I bought it, but I did. And I've absolutely got no regrets whatsoever, because it's a really good record. It's one that I play quite a lot, and I guess it's kind of opened my mind, perhaps, to, different types of music that I wouldn't normally listen to. I really liked Tina Turner in her younger days. If you ever get a chance, look out for some of the footage of Tina Turner in Ike and Tina Turner on YouTube. She was a real dynamo, you know. Her performances are just incredible. I recommend looking out for some of that. Really good. So that was a blind buy, and I'm glad that I got it. favourite place to buy records? Well, I've got a few favourite places, I guess, depending on where I am. I think that in Sweden, the best, my favourite place to buy records is the shop Mjölner. I've shown quite a lot of records that I got from there just recent on a recent trip. Mjölner is like a big, it's a chain, a sort of a chain of thrift stores in Sweden, run by the Salvation Army. There's one particular one that's really quite close to where I lived for a while in Stockholm, and whenever I go there, I always come out with a pile of records. Depending on what the trend is at the time, they can be very cheap. So that's certainly one of my favourite places. In the United States, when I lived in California, Half Moon Bay, I used to love going to garage sales. They were fantastic. I used to like, I lived for a few months in Sacramento. Particularly in things good. Like Goodwill stores. I don't know how many there are in Sacramento, but there seem to be loads of them. And I would always find records there. I used to drop my kids off at school and daycare in the morning, because I'm self-employed, I work at home. So on my way home, I would stop off at whichever Goodwill store that I went past on the way home, and bag 4 or 5 albums, take them home. In a matter of weeks, I'd kind of collected a big stack, 200 or 300, maybe 400 albums, just through my trips back and forth, to leaving the kids to school in the morning. So that was pretty cool. I like those places. Goodwill. A lot of people say they don't like Goodwill because they never find what they're looking for. But I mean, it's the thrill of the chase for me. That's what I really enjoy. There's one really top-notch record store that I'm going to say now in Ventura. So that's further south in California. It's a record store called, what's his name? I can't remember now what it's called. But I'll write it here. I think I even have some footage of it, so I'll show that. I always get some great stuff, and it's so well priced. Brilliant. So I recommend that store if you happen to be passing through Ventura. In Wales, I don't really have any favourite one yet, to be honest with you. I quite like going to the charity shops if I have a good day. You know, sometimes there's a bit of a drag. You can look in 20 and you don't find a thing. Other times you can find something really cracking. So pick it up for pennies. So the next question was import record. I've got records from everywhere I've lived. I've lived in Sweden for a long time, bought a large part of my collection there. I lived in the UK, I was born in England, now I'm living in Wales, also lived in California. So in many ways, depending on where I'm living, my records are all pretty much imported. For one place or another. But what I will show is an odd record which I picked up recently in Sweden. Like a second-hand sale, thrift store type thing. I've never heard of this person before, but I picked it up because I thought it was unusual. I think she's Japanese. The writing's in a sort of Asian language. An EMI. It's not necessarily my kind of thing that I listen to, but it's got an interesting cover version on it of a track. Oh, it's even got a little poster on it too. It's got a cover version of a track of that I like, so I thought I'd do a needle drop of that for you to listen to at the end of this video. Okay, John, I think I've answered all your questions now. Thanks very much for watching, everybody. Oh, and Don't forget to subscribe to Sloop John H's channel. Great channel. I've enjoyed it from when he started it, and it's great to see you back, John. All right. Thanks very much. Bye.